egg.
Hi guys, it's Muskan. I hope everyone is safe. I hope everyone's doing well. So today I'm very excited to be collaborating with Femina Focus. I'm going to show you guys my everyday makeup tutorial that I do. I hope you guys enjoy this. I've already moisturized my face and I've put serum. So I'm going to start off with the Bobbi Brown Intensive Skin Serum. This is not full coverage, but you know, it doesn't make, like, the makeup doesn't look cakey at all. And I'm just going to put it all over my face. This is a damp beauty blender and I'm just going to blend. So I love doing my makeup like a form of self-care. I think the first time that I actually started doing makeup was the day of my 13th birthday party. I remember going up to my mom's room and like I was going through her eyeshadow kit and I was wearing this blue and green dress. So I decided to put green eyeshadow all over my lid. I looked crazy, but I actually started loving makeup. So now I'm gonna start with concealer. I use two different concealers. So the first one that I'm using is the Bobbi Brown Instant Full Cover Concealer. It's this, it's in the shade beige. So I'm gonna put just the tiniest amount under my eye, just like that much. And then I'm going to use the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer in the shade Medium to Ginger. This is my favorite concealer, like I'm obsessed with this. So I'm just gonna add that all over. Okay, and I'm gonna blend that out again with the beauty blender. I'm using like the tiniest amount because I don't want it to look so cakey and like, so I'm just keeping it as natural as possible. I feel like makeup really allows me to like express myself creatively. I feel like it's not just about dressing up for me. You know, as an Indian woman, I've grown up with such toxic beauty standards around me, whether it's on billboards or advertisements, the list is never ending. So I feel like I really used makeup to sort of conceal my features to fit into the conventional beauty standards that were there. But I feel like now makeup has really given me a lot of self-confidence. It's made me really fall in love with my skin and made me accept all my flaws. So now that I've blended all of that, I'm going to set my under eyes with a little bit of powder. This is the Laura Mercier powder. I'm just going to take a very small amount. Just like that. And I'm going to leave it on for a little bit. Okay, I look crazy. I haven't done my eyebrows, guys, for like, even like I think maybe 3 months now, so it's become really thick. So I'm not gonna do too much. I'm just gonna go ahead and define it and sort of brush it up a little bit so it looks neater. I hate doing my brows. Now I'm gonna set them with a brow gel. This is the Benefit 24-hour brow setter. I definitely feel like brands have started becoming, or like makeup brands in general and the beauty industry in general, has become more inclusive for women of different you know, skin tones, but there's still so much that needs to be done. You know, a lot of the women who have a darker complexion find it really difficult to find their own shade. But for example, like Fenty Beauty by Rihanna, I think she has about 40 different shades catering to like women of all skin tones, and I feel like every makeup brand should start adopting that. In my opinion, I really see that whenever a makeup brand posts something for their product, we see more of an idealized version of a woman, and I just feel like it needs to be a little more realistic. Really important for the beauty industry and the fashion industry in general to be more inclusive and more diverse. So now I'm gonna start with my eyeshadow. I'm gonna use the Huda Beauty palette. And I'm also going to use the Charlotte Tilbury palette. So these are my favorite eyeshadow palettes. Okay, so I'm going to use the shade Teddy and I'm going to go over my entire lid. I'm really bad at doing eyeshadow. So now I'm going to take a darker shade. I think I'm going to go with Raw and Tease and sort of blend those and just make my crease a little darker. A little darker shade. Colorism has always been such a big issue all over the world, and it's been such a deep-rooted issue in India. I come across so many advertisements that promote the use of fairness creams and products, and it can really harm the self-esteem of a woman who has a darker complexion, because in a way you're telling them that, oh, like, you're not good enough because of your skin color. It's really important for us to finally voice our opinion, and as a society we need to understand that dark is beautiful. I definitely feel like, you know, colorism has created such a toxic beauty standards that we need to be confident in our own skin. So now I'm going to use the Charlotte Tilbury palette, and I'm going to use the really, like, this shimmery. I'm going to apply that all over the lid. This is what I do all the time, guys. I don't have another routine for my eyeshadow. One of my really good friends, Naomi, she's a model and she's doing so well for herself, and she's just so insanely beautiful and talented. I was speaking to her about this issue of colorism in general, and she was speaking to me about how she's always grown up thinking that dark is not beautiful, but, you know, now she feels so much more confident in her own skin and she really doesn't need to listen to the beauty standards that are there. And I think she's also using her platform to voice her opinion, and I think it's so important for people to do that now. I am so bad at doing my eyeliner. I take like 15 minutes to do my eyeliner because I'm so scared all the time. I'm using the YSL eyeliner. I like to darken my under eyes well. So I'm just gonna use the same shades, Raw and Tease. I think it really, like, makes the eye pop. This is the Bad Gal Bang by Benefit. It's the best mascara ever.
Oh my God, this is gonna be tragic.
Time for bronzer. I just used the Hoola bronzer by Benefit. I've been using this for years now, guys. It's the best for the jawline. I use the NARS blush. I literally just highlight the bridge of my nose because it just makes the entire look pop. Onto lips, I'm using the MAC. This is Whirl. So I overline them a little bit because I really like how it looks. Like, it gives a fuller lip. Take it inside as well. If I want, I'll go ahead and add like a lip gloss to it, but like, since it's like an everyday sort of thing, I don't really do that. Okay guys, so this is the final makeup look. I hope you guys enjoyed this. It's just a very easy, you know, daytime get ready with me. I wanted to take a quick minute talking about a few Indian charities that I've donated to recently. The first one is Uday Foundation. It's so important because they serve a lot of the underprivileged children that are there in the government hospitals, and also a lot of children who come from far off places and, you know, require more time for their treatment, so it serves to them as well. So the second charity that I donated to was Feeding India. Feeding India really looks at designing various interventions to tackle the problem of hunger and also, you know, provide for the underserved communities of India. It's so important to donate. You know, the smallest amount can make a big difference. So please, please, please donate, guys. I'll leave a few links to charities in India that I really love and admire, so you guys can go visit them and spread awareness. Also, I just wanted to say that, you know, I know that there's so much going on in the world right now. You know, our generation is so powerful, and the only way that we can actually make a change is by speaking up. So I think that's so important.